It all starts with a dead girl. Ever since I was little, I've had this dream. It's the end of summer. A girl is running through the woods. The moon, the scent of pines. And then the gunshot. It always felt so real. The blood on my cheek, the cold sweat running down my skin. I'd managed to convince myself it really happened, this scar of a memory. A part of me I could never fully understand. Well, that wasn't the only part. No wonder people used to think I was strange. If they only knew. That day when the phone rang, it was the hardest day of my life. The day I went home to say goodbye to my father. Dress him up for his last journey. Put him in a suit, fix his tie. Simple. Just the things he did every day. But looking through his stuff wasn't easy. I needed a moment to pull myself together. I was almost ready. I just had to find his special tie clip. Yeah. Nice to see you, too. Weird to be back in my old room. So many memories. Kids from the orphanage. Not all of them had my luck. That's why I kept coming back. To play. To get to listen. That was the least I could do. Spirits. There was a time I'd try to run from them. to ignore their... Matthew was the first one. I used to have a thing for them. Don't know why, really. I guess they just used to make me happy. Jack knew it well. That's why there's so many of them here. I used to get a lot of these. To me, they were like trophies. Badges of honor for doing the right thing. Jack wasn't too amused, but he did his best to cover for me. I kind of feel bad for making him go through all. My oldest family heirloom. As a kid, I'd show this to people just to freak them out. I'd usually say something like, pretty... I was such a dwarf. Room. It's like he never... Damn it. Jack was part of the Solidarity movement. He spent a few months in an internment camp, but even that couldn't... Come on, Jack. Where'd you put it? Okay. Let's do this the other way. There you are. Okay, I think that's it. Jack's waiting downstairs. Time to say goodbye. I can't believe it's all still here. Oh, Jack. Looks nourishing. I guess I forgot about this one. I can do it now. missed my window. Now it's overexposed. Photo I took of you, Jack. Shit. We lived upstairs from Jack's funeral home. It wasn't as weird as it sounds. Besides, if it wasn't for that, I may never have learned to use my powers. Jack taught me to accept my condition. Of all my foster parents, he was the only one who saw it as a gift and not a curse. Jack's in the prep room. Here it is. not sure if I'm ready for this. Hey, Jack. Got your special clip? No. Where's your tie? Snazzy. You wouldn't have it any other way. I didn't expect this to be easy. I guess I didn't know what to expect. When things get personal, it just burns you from the inside out. You're ready. But am I? People read. The sign says closed. You felt it too, huh? And then it happened. As it did so many times before. Just when I thought my day couldn't get any worse.
Oh, where is that darn notebook? I'm gonna be late. I need to find that. Marianne? Marianne, are you crying, my child?
It's fine, Jack.
Now, you didn't happen to see my notebook, did you, darling? My memory's a bit fuzzy. So much for aging gracefully.
Probably get some rest. Forget the notebook.
Oh, no, no. I've got so much work, my dear.
It's okay, Jack.
I can't just... What?
Let it go. It's not important.
You are crying. What's wrong, dear? Why is it so cold in here? Where is that?
It's okay, Jack. It's okay.
My sweet little Marianne. What would I ever do without you?
Jack. Don't worry about it. It's time to get some rest.
Oh, Marianne.
Yeah?
Oh, I'm worried about the surgery. When I'm at the hospital, are you sure you're going to be all right?
Yes, Jack. It's going to be fine.
I promised myself once I would never let anything happen to you. Not while I'm around.
I'll be fine. I promise.
No risky stuff, then. Huh? All right?
All right, Jack. Yeah. Get some rest.
I need... Oh, yes, yes. Be good, Marianne. I love you, my child. I've loved you since the moment you walked into my life. Remember that. Always.
Most people would give anything to have that opportunity. To say all the things that were left unsaid. But it didn't make things any easier. I could help 1,000 souls cross over, but when it came to Jack, it still hurt like hell.
I love you too, Daddy.
I used to think everyone saw the world the way I did. Divided, torn between two realities. But no, I was the only one. Or so I thought.
We're closed. There's another funeral home across town. I can give you the number.
Marianne.
Who is this?
You don't know me, Marianne. But I know you.
Look, if this is a joke...
You need to listen to me, Marianne.
Okay, I'm hanging up.
I know what you are.
What? Who is this?
My name is Thomas. I need your help.
Listen, if that's all you've got, I'm...
No, there's more. I can give you the answers you've been looking for your whole life. I need you to trust me.
Trust you? I don't even know you.
It all starts with a dead girl.
What did you say?
The Neva Resort. Find me there. Please. The light, it's almost gone. It's not dark yet, but it's getting there. You're the only one who can stop it. You're my only chance.
Hello? Hello? Shit.
Thank you.
And off I went, on nothing but a hunch. A call from a complete stranger. But I'd learned to trust my instincts, and there was something about this guy, his voice. I felt like I should know him. Either way, he sure seemed to know me. The Neva Workers Resort. Right off the bat, I could feel there was something off about that place. Anyone home? I guess not. Hello? Thomas? The front gate was locked up tight. I needed to find another way in. You want to keep me out, Neva? We're gonna have to do better than that. Not a whole lot of people knew about Neva. It used to be a government-owned vacation resort. Until one day it just stopped. And so an urban legend was born. The Neva Massacre. The details were always fuzzy. Crazed workers, ancient curses. You know, the usual. Hello. What's this? Thank you. might be my way in. Something happened here. The split would come and go. If a place had a story to tell, well, I guess I was there to listen. Dead. Like everything else in this place. Yeah, not getting through here. Not with the power out. When you exist in two realities, you're affected by either. I'd learned that the hard way. The place felt old and soaked in misery. Figures, I guess. 1,000 years of history doesn't just happen. It's paid for. But even in the deepest darkness, light can linger. Lonely, fragile, waiting for someone to embrace it. As I absorbed the energy, I wondered who it was that left it behind. A dying soldier whispering the name of his beloved? Or maybe just glad to be done with this world? In any case, I figured I could use it. Energy's energy, right?
Oh, so that worked. Good for you, Marianne.
These powers of mine, as much of a pain in the ass as they were, they did come in handy sometimes. So there I was, existing in two worlds, but never really living in either. To you. What the hell are you, Neva? The aura in that place. I've seen others like it, but never this intense. It was like a landfill of memories, emotions, and none of them good.
Hello? Anybody in there?
Locked. Obviously. There's gotta be another way.